I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
I've had the opportunity to fight at the likes of, you know, MGM,
Madison Square Garden, right?
Madison Square Garden, New York. Not the Staples, the Barclays Center. So I fought around the US, probably quite lucky that when you fight in the US, you become a global star because everyone around the world, I guess, can see you fight. But I've been quite lucky where, you know, I go to the airport and, you know, I'll always get people coming over to me saying, we'll be fine anyway. Hey, I'm here, how's it going? And I'll be quite shocked because sometimes I'm like dressed down,
I go
minding my own business, thinking that no one knows me. Having a little laugh with my wife and messing around with her or my little girls.
Pictures
and people are taking pictures from far away and I'm like, hey, just come by and come say hi and take a picture probably, you know?
You gotta tell me what happened. You were in Ireland and Conor McGrgeor and you had a face-off and he was sizing you up. Does he want to fight you?
I mean, nah, you know, I mean, I met Conor. I think he's a lovely guy. We met in Ireland. I was invited to Brave MMA Championship. So I went there, Conor was there. And I said hi to him, and he was so respectful, honestly, such a respectful guy. You know, a lot of people think he's cocky, he's a bit full of himself, but he's not, you know, he's a gentleman. And he respects fighters. Maybe he does it for show, he does it for cameras, but other than that, I mean, he's a great guy. So we spoke, and he said to me that he watched my fight against Canelo. He respected me a lot for going up 2-3 weight divisions.
And you were winning that fight.
Yeah, man, and he said the same thing. But then, obviously, he said he made the same mistake when he fought against...
Nate,
weight divisions to fight him as well. So, you know, it's I respect what he did and he respects me to fight. But, you know, we were deciding each other up. I tell you one thing, though, he's huge, bro. I mean, he was stood next to me and he looked really, really big and strong. So,
Did you invite him to come train with you?
I did, yeah. He said next time he's in LA, he's going to come back to the gym and train with me. He said, he took my number down and everything. I said, look, let's keep in touch. And, yeah, lovely guy, man.
He's a very nice person. In the beginning, you know, I'm friends with Nate, and you know that, and you train with Nate.
Yeah.
So, he was fighting Nate, so he didn't like me in the beginning, but then we had a good talk.
You know what? It's business in the day. Look, in the day, he's not going to like people who are going to be promoting the other side of the opponent. Before you fight the guy, your opponent, you don't like the people around him. You don't like him. But after the fight, you know, we put that away. We kind of get on with the team. And I'm sure that's what he went through because I know you're a good friend with Nate Diaz.
Yeah.
So Conor must have seen that you're always around him and stuff, and probably thought that you're one of his guys. But after the fight, he's probably forgot about that and he's keeping it cool with you.
He asked me one thing he wanted to know. He said, "Elie, who pays for your flight and your hotel?" I said, "What do you mean?" He
goes, "Self-paid."
Yeah. I said, "Oh, now I respect you. Now I respect you."
I said, "That's what I respect about you, bro, man. You know, you get a lot of these other guys who want boxers to pay for them to." Fund them, you know, to fly here, fly there. Food, hotels. But what I respect about you, Elie, is you've never asked for a dime to any fighter.
Why?
And it's like, for example, when I started training with Joe Goosen back in the Bay Area, you came all the way to Undisputed Gym and at your own expense filmed and drove back the same day. And I was like, so you did like a 6-hour drive there, 6-hour back. So you had an all day.
In the rain, it was vision.
In the rain as well. So now I respect you for that, man. And the day, there's a lot of people who don't realize the work you put into it behind the scenes.
One thing about Conor, he went 10 rounds with Mayweather. For a guy who never boxed professionally and even won one or two rounds at the beginning, that was very impressive.
Yeah, man. I mean, he said that it was... he really wanted to kick in there, you know? I mean, MMA is totally different to boxing, so you have to take your hats off to McGrgeor. I mean, he put on a great fight against Mayweather. We all know that Mayweather was going to be more skillful and I box him, but still he gave it a try, and guess what, won a couple of rounds in there, so credit due to him, you know, he deserves it.
Would you ever fight Conor if it came up, or?
I mean, as business it makes sense, yeah, but
if it sells,
if it's
Wembley Stadium or O2 Arena?
I mean, that would sell in Wembley easy. I mean, Conor McGrgeor is a big name worldwide now. I mean, he's a superstar, isn't he? So whoever he fights, I think, would make big names.
His
would
fans make big love names. Him.
He's got a big name, man.
You have fans that love you, so.
Yeah, I mean, we were together, we sat there and people are coming over to both of us and taking pictures. And, you know, I'm humbled by it all, man, honestly. Like, boxing is what I do, and I love boxing. And with boxing, I got so much love from the fans all around the world, man. So,
how did the face-off happen?
He just stood in front of me and he kind of held me.
Squared you up.
Squared me up and kind of...
I told you, he was sizing you up.
Maybe, but I tell you one thing, he was huge. So I kind of grabbed him from there and I thought, like, I couldn't put my hand around his arms. His arms are huge. Shoulders were big. So, but when he was sort of stood in front of me, he must have been at least 40 pounds heavier. I mean, he looked big. But look, it finished off, we shook hands, I walked off, And yeah, man, I think he's a great fighter. I'm a fan.
You okay? You coming off a fight? He's been off for a long time. I hope he has some legal trouble. Hopefully it works out for the best.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.